When your product has a nasty bug that's impacting a lot of users, your first priority is to put a fix in that's going to help resolve it. And you might hear your developer say something like,
"Yeah, I'll just put in a quick fix."
A week may go by, maybe possibly a month, and you've got another nasty bug on your hand. And your developer might tell you,
"No problem, I'll have that bug resolved by the end of the day."
Later on, you might ask them to put in a new feature, and they may respond with,
"Yeah, it's gonna take a while."
How long?
Weeks, possibly months.
Weeks, possibly months? Why so long?
Tech debt.
Wondering what's tech debt, how to avoid it, and prevent it before it gets too unwieldy? Well, I'm gonna answer these questions and many more in today's quick build tip. Welcome to Build, brought to you by Pivotal Tracker. I'm your host, Purnima Vijayashankar, and today I've got a build tip for you. I'm joined by Jay Hub, who is a product manager at Pivotal. So Jay, tell me, what's tech debt?
So tech debt is the effort that builds up when a team makes a conscious decision to implement code that's easy instead of building out our best solution.
Okay, so what is that actually?
So the easy to implement quick messy code is the debt. And like any type of debt, it accrues interest over time. And so the additional effort that is built up that could either be time, money, or resources is the technical debt that builds up that makes it much more difficult in the long run to implement a better solution.
So how can we avoid tech debt?
So here's the interesting thing. Tech debt is usually thought of as a bad thing, something that needs to be paid down very quickly or avoided as much as possible or altogether. However, tech debt is actually unavoidable. So much like financial debt, there is not necessarily good technical debt, but there is technical debt that you can deal with. So an example is in the mortgage or student loan, where the principal plus the interest that you accrue could be lower than what you actually yield in terms of the investment, right? Now, any experienced or seasoned developer are always wanting to create the best possible solution that there is out there. However, sometimes you need to incur technical debt in order to get a product out to market quicker. So generally, the time to market or the time pressure is what makes technical debt unavoidable.
Okay, it's unavoidable. But how can we manage it while continuing to meet customer needs and pushing features out?
Well, here's the thing about technical debt that makes this sort of the analogy to financial debt a little dissimilar. So you don't actually have to pay down technical debt. So for instance, when you're building out a product or service, there could be parts of the code that aren't used very often or not touched or don't need to be changed. So that the ROI on actually paying down that debt or refactoring doesn't get you much, or doesn't get you anything there. So one of the other ways to really look at it and approach it is build in technical debt into the product roadmap or how you plan out your releases. Right. And when you think about it, you should be thinking about it in terms of what's the upside potential versus the downside risk of either paying down technical debt or not paying down technical debt, and relate that to, again, getting a product or service out to the market quicker or spending more time and writing more cleaner quality code.
All right. That's great that we don't always have to pay down tech debt and that it's okay to accumulate it. But how do we know when to make the trade-off of paying it down versus just letting it exist?
Right. So one of the things that you want to look at is what is the probability of occurrence of something bad happening, or the probability of occurrence of you having to do a major refactor because the technical debt has just gotten so big. And coupled with that, you also want to look at what is the impact. So again, there's smaller technical debt where the impact of paying it down is not very big. But again, there's other parts where the technical debt can be very big, could lead to a big regression. And what is the impact on the delay to the market or the impact to the customer that are actually using your product that's in the market right now?
So do you have an example of a situation where you don't need to pay down the tech debt versus one where you do?
Sure, yeah. I think a really good example would be if you take a look at an app and through your analytics and you're looking at one of the features that you've implemented is not being used very often, right? So this is a good example of you probably don't want to pay down technical debt on that feature because, again, it's not a lot of people that are using it. And conversely, there's the flip side. So if you see that there is a feature that's being used very heavily by your users and that they're clamoring for a feature that is sort of an add-on to that feature, then this is an instance where you would want to pay down technical debt quickly. quickly so that you can build out that new feature that is an add-on to the existing feature.
What happens if you leave tech debt around for too long? Is there ever a point where it's too late to pay it down?
There are instances where it is too late, and usually what that manifests itself is that you have to do a big rewrite, which not a lot of people enjoy doing, both from the customer perspective as well as the development team. But if you go back to what I said earlier, if you realize that tech debt is unavoidable and you put it, build it into your product strategy and your product roadmap, then there's ways of being able to manage that tech debt at a good pace so that you never have to end up with having to do a big rewrite.
Thanks, Jay. This has been really helpful. Do you have any other resources for our audiences to check out?
Yes, they should check out this article written by the Agile Alliance. It is called Introduction to Technical Debt Concept, and it goes much more deeper into some of the concepts that I discussed here around technical debt.
Now, Jay and I want to know, how do you guys handle tech debt at your company? Let us know in the comments below this video. Okay, that's it for today's bill tip. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to receive more great episodes of Build and Build Tips like today's. And special thanks to our sponsor, Pivotal Tracker, for their help in producing today's episode. Ciao for now.